Welcome once again for this third lecture in worm gear. So already we are familiar with the basics of the worm gear in first and second lecture. Myself Dr. A.G. Kulkarni from SKNC Institute, Department of Mechanical Engineering. So in lecture 1 and lecture 2 we have seen the introductory part of the worm and worm gear. Then we have seen the terminology in second lecture, and then in third lecture we will observe the geometrical relationship between worm and worm wheel, and that particular relations will be required in order to identify the addendum, dedendum, as well as the basic terms which are our basic things like face width, etc. So we'll go for the geometrical relationships. So before going to that, at the last lecture we have seen that in terminology this is the way of representation, or this is the reference with the preferred values of number of starts, then number of teeth, the diametrical coefficients and module, center distance versus transmission ratio, and this is the available values. Is it okay? So in geometrical relationships, if we refer this particular figure, then this is worm and this is worm wheel. So in this worm, the terms which are shown here, inside that this worm HA1, so this always we are representing as addendum, and HF1 we are always representing as a dedendum. Is it okay? So this addendum and dedendums, C shows the clearance. So in case of worm as well as in case of worm wheel, so A1 represents worm, and if it is 2 then it represents worm wheel. Is it okay? So HA1 that represents addendum of worm, HF1 represents dedendum of worm. Is it okay? So likewise here, if we see this particular worm, then for the HA, this particular DF1, HF1 and HA1 which are shown here, so HA1 represents the addendum of worm and HF1 represents this particular dedendum of worm. Is it okay? So here we will refer like this. Then next to that we have to see that this particular worm, the relationship between this addendum and dedendum. So see here, if DA1 represents the addendum diameter, so for this worm, if we observe this particular diameter, our outside diameter we consider as addendum diameter and root diameter. So this is outside diameter means with reference to this edge. Is it okay? So this is outside diameter. So DA1, D1 is the diameter, we may consider this as pitch circle diameter, and DF1, so that represents the root diameter. So root diameter, addendum diameter and pitch circle diameter. Likewise DA1 is the addendum diameter, D1 pitch circle diameter, and DF1 that will be dedendum diameter. Is it okay? So now in order to identify this addendum diameter DA1, we are using the relation DA1 is equal to D1 plus 2 times of HA1. So this 2 times of HA1 represents 2 times of addendum is added here. Now as we know that D1 is equal to QM, and this particular addendum diameter is equal to 1 module. So that's why HA1 is equal to M. So DA1 is equal to QM plus 2M. Is it okay? So this DA1 is given as, by taking M as a common, Q plus 2. So addendum diameter of the worm is given as M into bracket Q plus 2. Is it okay? Now in order to identify the dedendum diameter, we are going to subtract the dedendum. So as two sides are there, so that's why 2 times of dedendum. Is it okay? So dedendum diameter is equal to, or root diameter is equal to, D1 minus 2 times of HF1. Is it okay? So as usual, this D1 we are considering as Q times of M, and this particular dedendum which is given by 2.2 cos gamma minus 1 into M. Is it okay? So dedendum HF1 is represented by M into bracket 2.2 cos gamma minus 1. Is it okay? So this DF1, by simplifying, we are getting as M into bracket Q plus 2 minus 4.4 cos gamma. So already we are familiar with this gamma. Gamma is lead angle. Is it okay? So addendum diameter and dedendum diameter in case of worm, that is represented here. Now here, by observing this particular figure, we can see that this particular DA2 is the addendum diameter in worm wheel. D2 represents pitch circle diameter of worm wheel, and DF2 represents the root diameter or addendum diameter of worm wheel. So indirectly that represents HA2 is the addendum of worm wheel, HF2 is addendum of worm wheel. Is it okay? So HA2, HF2. Now here if we observe this HA2 and HF2, so these terms are related with worm wheel. So addendum in case of worm wheel and addendum in case of worm wheel are represent with the help of this relationship. Addendum is given as in case of worm wheel m into bracket 2 cos gamma minus 1. Addendum is given as m into bracket 1 plus 0.2 cos gamma. Okay, so gamma represents lead angle, m is module. With reference to that, now we can have the addendum diameter and addendum diameter in case of worm wheel. So DA2 represents addendum diameter of worm wheel. Obviously, it is D2 plus 2 times of HA2. D2 represents pitch circle diameter, and this 2 times of addendum from both sides is added, and then this particular D2 is used, this MZ2, we have used D2 is equal to MZ2, the relationship between module and diameter number of teeth with reference to that. Then this particular HA2 is nothing but M into bracket 2 cos gamma minus 1. So simplified form of addendum diameter in case of worm wheel is given as M into bracket Z2 plus 4 cos gamma minus 2. Similarly, addendum diameter in case of worm wheel, that is given as D2 minus 2 times of HF2. D2 is the pitch circle diameter, and this 2 times of HF2 is the subtracted from both sides, that is addendum. And then by substituting HF2 is equal to M into bracket 1 plus 0.2 cos gamma, in earlier we have written this particular relationships here. So that relationships represents these particular values. Is it okay? So same values we have used here, and with reference to that addendum and addendum in case of worm wheel, and with reference to that addendum diameter and addendum diameter in case of worm wheel, that is identified. Is it okay? Okay. So one more term. So up till now in geometrical relationships we have seen addendum diameter in case of worm, addendum diameter in case of worm wheel, addendum diameter in case of worm, and addendum diameter in case of worm wheel. Is it okay? And two more terminologies, two more geometrical relationships we have to see here, inside which one is the face width. So this particular width, in this diagram we can see that this particular width, is it okay? So this width is the width of worm wheel. So width of the worm wheel, which is given here, which is represented by letter F. Is it okay? So F represents face width of worm wheel. So this F value, so this particular circle shows the addendum in case of worm. This is pitch circle diameter, addendum diameter, pitch circle diameter, and addendum diameter in case of worm. Is it okay? So DA1, D1. And so this particular we may consider as DF1. Is it okay? So these are the diameters, addendum diameter, pitch circle diameter, and addendum diameter. And if we observe here, so this center O from which this A, B, C, these constructions initially we will understand. So this particular center is O. So this particular distance OA represents the addendum diameter, OB is also addendum diameter, OC will be pitch circle diameter, and this XYZ, so this particular arc, is it okay? So the XYZ is the arc, and this is the face width. Okay, and then one by one we'll see. First initially we'll go for the face width. So by referring the figure, AC square is equal to AO square minus OC square. So AC square, so here you may represent AC square is shown in the figure, AC square, AO square. So this AO is the hypotenuse of this particular right angle triangle. AO square minus OC square is equal to AC square, is it okay? By observing this particular right angle triangle, we have written here AC square is equal to AO square minus OC square, is it okay? Then AC represents, this AC is nothing but half of the face width, because total face width is AB and AC is half face width. So half face width is given here as F by 2. So F represent face width, F by 2. AO is the addendum, so radius, we may consider addendum radius or half of addendum diameter. So half of addendum diameter, that's why DA1 divided by 2, it's a square. And then this particular D1 by 2. So OC is nothing but this particular distance OC, if we observe here. So this is pitch circle diameter, half of pitch circle diameter. So this particular pitch circle diameter and half of that pitch circle diameter. So OC represents half of pitch circle diameter. So AO square minus OC square is equal to AC square, where AO is DA1 by 2, OC is D1 by 2. Is it okay? Then AC square is substituted here as F by 2, AO as DA1 by 2 and OC as D1 by 2. Is it okay? And then substituting these values here, as already we know that addendum diameter is given as M into bracket Q plus 2. So addendum diameter in case of worm is given as M into bracket Q plus 2, and pitch circle diameter in case of worm is given as QM. Is it okay? Already in terminology we have seen these two things. Substituted that values here, M into bracket Q plus 2 divided by 2 and this particular QM. Is it okay? By substituting and giving here it as square. So this face width F simplified this particular, and by simplifying this face width we have got M 2M into bracket under root Q plus 1. Is it okay? So this simplifying this particular equation, face width is observed equal to 2m under root q plus 1. Okay. Now side by side one more term we have to see, that is this angle delta. So this referring to this figure, so this particular angle delta, sine delta we may consider as c1z upon oz. Is it okay? So which is used here, c1 delta, sine delta is equal to c1z upon oz. So C1Z is nothing but, so this is again half of this face width. So this is F by 2 and OZ. So this particular distance inside that O2 this up to this one, this is addendum diameter and this is clearance. Is it okay? So this is DA1 and this particular clearance is added here. For sake of simplicity, it is written as DA1 plus 2C upon C. So indirectly this is DA1 by 2 plus C, however for sake of simplicity it is written as DA1 plus 2C upon 2. Okay. So OZ, so substituted here C1Z is equal to F by 2 and OZ is equal to DA1 plus 2C upon 2. And by simplifying it we got this angle delta is equal to sine inverse of F upon DA1 plus 2C. Okay. So this clearance C, so the clearance between this worm and worm wheel. C represents clearance, and that is clearance between worm and worm wheel. That is given as 0.2m cos gamma. So this is the clearance. So the length of root of worm and worm wheel is rxyz, which is denoted by LR. So this is xyz. So this is LR. So this is considered to be arc length. Is it okay? So length of the root of the worm wheel teeth is arc xyz and denoted by LR. So LR is arc xyz. So this arc length is given as, so with reference to this figure, if we refer the figure, so arc length is given as LR. Is it okay? So LR is here xyz, this particular length. Okay. So more clarification on this arc length, which is given here. So by substituting these values, this LR is represented as LR is equal to DA1 plus 2C sine inverse of F upon DA1 plus 2C. Okay, so we'll add some more clarification in next lecture on that one. Okay, thank you.